Hi, everyone. My name is Laura. I'm a biologist with the Immune Tolerance Network, and today I'm going to be demonstrating the procedure for separating PBMCs from whole blood. And we're going to be using SepMate tubes. These tubes might look a little bit like a normal 50 mil conical, but if you can see on the inside there, there's a plastic insert that has a small hole in the center, so it's a little bit like a funnel. And these tubes are going to make it a lot easier to remove the red blood cells. So before we start, we want to make sure that our PBS and our lympho prep, as well as our blood sample and our centrifuge, are all at room temperature. Now I've divided the protocol into four parts to make it a little bit easier, so let's get started with part one. All right, now the first step is going to be to prepare four SepMate tubes by adding 15 milliliters of lympho prep to each tube. Now I'm going to use the graduations on the pipette, not the graduations on the tube here. And what you might be able to see is that I'm just going to put the tip of the pipette just above the central hole on the SepMate tube and slowly drip the lympho prep through that hole. All right, there we go. And as you hopefully can see, the surface of the liquid is actually just a little bit above the top of that plastic insert, and that's the way it should be. Okay, now I'm gonna repeat that process for my other three SepMate tubes, and then we'll move on to the next step. All right, now to prepare the blood, I'm going to take my four blood tubes. Ideally, you should have 40 mils. And I'm going to combine all of that blood into one regular 50 mil conical tube. All right, so now I've got my 40 mils of blood in a conical tube. I'm just going to split that into an empty conical tube. So I've got 20 mils and 20 mils. All right, now I'm ready to dilute my blood with some room temperature DPBS. So I'm going to add an equal volume of DPBS to each tube of blood. So I'm going to add 20 mils of DPBS. And then I'm going to pipette up and down. All right, now I'm just going to repeat that same process with the other tube of blood. All right, now we're ready for part two, and this is the fun part. This is where we get to separate the PBMCs from the red blood cells. So you should have two 50 ml conicals with your diluted whole blood, and you should have four SepMate tubes, each containing 15 ml of lympho prep. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to very carefully drip 20 mils of the diluted blood down the side of that SepMate tube, and it's going to sit on top of the lympho prep media. Let me show you. Okay. So I'm going to put my pipette tip on the side of the SepMate tube. And I'm just going to slowly pipette down the side of the tube, and the blood should stay on top. Now it's really tempting to tip the SepMate tube a little bit, but it's actually important that you keep it upright. All right, so this is what it should look like. You might notice that the blood has mixed with a little bit of the lymphoprep media above the plastic insert. That's okay. You might also be able to see there's a tiny bit of blood below the plastic insert. That's okay as well. All right, now I'm going to repeat this with the other three tubes until I've used up all my blood. All right, now that I've got all of my blood carefully layered over my lymphoprep in my SepMate tubes, I'm going to very gently walk this over to the centrifuge. And when I spin it, the red blood cells will pellet to the bottom of the tube, but the PBMCs and the plasma will stay on top. And I'll show you what that looks like. All right, I'm back from the centrifuge. Now let me show you what these tubes look like. And so what you should see is red blood cells pelleted at the bottom, then a clear layer, that's the lymphoprep, and then sort of a cloudy yellow layer, and that's the plasma with the PBMCs in it. And the cool thing about these SepMate tubes is that to get the plasma and PBMCs separated from the red blood cells, we're just going to pour it off, and that plastic insert is going to help keep the red blood cells behind. All right, now I'm ready to pour off my PBMCs from my SepMate tube into a clean, empty 50 mil conical. So I'm going to invert the SepMate tube in one smooth, confident motion. One, two, right side up again. And so what you should be left with is your red blood cells. Those can get thrown away, and your plasma plus your PBMCs. Now I'm just gonna repeat that process with the other three tubes. So now I want to take a moment just to demonstrate what happens when you don't pour off your PBMCs in that smooth, confident motion that I described. So here I have the SepMate tube that just has the red blood cells left in it. So if I turn it upside down, nothing comes out. But if I hold it at a 45 degree angle, you can see the red blood cells start to fall out. So this is where we want to avoid holding the tube at this angle while we're pouring off our PBMCs, because it might cause us to get a little bit of red blood cell contamination, which we're trying to avoid. Now we're ready for part three, and the first step is to wash our PBMCs. So now I have my four tubes containing about 20 milliliters of diluted plasma with PBMCs that I poured off of the SepMate tubes. And so there's about 20 mils in there. I'm gonna add 30 mils of DPBS to bring it up to 50. And this is important to wash the PBMCs to remove that lymphoprep. There's one, I'm gonna repeat that with the other three tubes, and then I'm gonna take them to the centrifuge. Now I'm going to spun my cells. Let's look at the cell pellet. So hopefully you can see there's a little pellet. It's a little bit pink because there are a few red blood cells, but that's all right. So now I'm going to very carefully remove the supernatant from all four of my tubes, being careful not to disturb the cell pellet at the bottom of the tube. So now I'm going to resuspend each of the four cell pellets in 10 milliliters of DPBS. And I'm going to pipette each one up and down to resuspend it. Now the other thing I'm going to do in this step is I'm going to combine all of these cells from four tubes into one. So the way I'm going to do that is I'm going to resuspend my second cell pellet in 10 mils of DPBS. I'm going to pipette up and down. And then I'm just going to immediately transfer it to the first tube where I already suspended the cells. Now I'm going to do the same thing with tube number three and tube number four. Ten mils DPBS, pipette up and down. And I'm going to combine that with the rest of the cells. Number 4, 10 mils, pipe that up and down. And now I'm going to combine it with the rest of the cells. So now you've got one tube with 40 mils with all of your cells, and you've got three tubes that are mostly empty. But just because these cells are so precious, I'm not gonna throw these away just yet. I'm gonna do one more 10 mil DPBS to rinse those three tubes and combine it with the other cells. So I'm gonna take 10 mils of DPBS. I'm going to put it into the first tube that I emptied. Pipette up and down just to pick up any leftover cells. Now I'm going to add it to the second tube that I emptied. Pipette up and down to pick up any leftover cells. And then I'm going to add it to the third tube that I emptied. So now I'm going to add this to the 40 mils that I have here to bring it up to 50. And these three tubes that are now empty and have been rinsed can get thrown away. And the one tube that I have left with all of my cells in 50 mils of DPBS, I'm going to centrifuge. All right, my cells just came out of the centrifuge. Now you can see the pellet there. It's a little bit pink. There are a few red blood cells. That's all right. So I'm just going to remove that supernatant, being careful not to disturb the pellet, of course. And then I'm ready for part 4. All right, you made it to part 4, freezing the cells, and we're almost done. So in this step, we're going to be resuspending our cell pellet in cryostore. But unlike the DPBS and the lympho prep, we actually want our cryostore to be cold. So I'm going to resuspend that pellet in 4 milliliters, and then I'm going to put 0.5 milliliter into each of 8 cryovials. I realize your cryovials might look a little bit different because I have a different brand, but don't worry about that. Once I have my cells in the cryovials, they're going to go into a Mr. Frosty, which should also be pre-chilled and filled with isopropanol. Thanks for watching, and good luck!